Hello, everybody. Welcome to another episode of Dulcimerica. My name is Bing Futch. Thanks for joining me for some more Dulcimer fun. And I don't know how you got here, but I'm glad you did. So thanks for being here and sharing the fun. You know, I got an email earlier this week from a friend who said, you know, do you have any tablature for I'll Fly Away? And I said, you know, I sure don't, but tell you what, I'm shooting this week. I'll go ahead and do a Dulcimerica on it since I play it in gospel jams all the time at festivals across the country, so I'll share that with you. Before we get into I'll Fly Away, however, I would like to give a big ol' shout out to one of my patrons on Patreon, Jan Camper. Jan, I've known you for a very long time, and I'm just so very, very happy and pleased as punch that you're one of my patrons. And you do a lot of really amazing work along with all of the patrons who contribute a little bit of money every single month to help me continue to do stuff like Dulcimerica, going on tour, recording new albums, creating new books, and all kinds of stuff. It's amazing, and I really appreciate your dedication, your friendship, and just being a part of this community. Thank you, Jan Camper, very, very much. Those of you wondering what this whole Patreon thing is all about, basically it's a way for people like yourself to help support artists like myself who are out here trying to do all kinds of things. For my personal Patreon drive, you can get for just $5 a month my entire CD collection, all of my self-published books, videos, high-definition quality versions of Dulcimerica, even better than the one you're watching right now, lots of tablature, lots of behind-the-scenes stuff that doesn't get seen anywhere else on the internet, and for as little as the cost of a cup of a venti caramel macchiato at Starbucks, you could have all of that and a lot more. Every new MP3 track I produced, every single new tablature, every single new page of a book goes directly to my patrons, and it is an exclusive club for people who are supporting my music, and it gives me the ability to do all kinds of neat stuff like upgrade equipment, take care of my vehicle on the road, and also present library and school programs for those places that do not have a budget to do so, because I love presenting and teaching music. So again, Jan, thank you very much for your part in making this thing sing. And everybody out there who's really curious, go ahead and check out the link down here. It's www.com/Patreon. Did I say two W's? I did. www.patreon.com/BingFutch. And when you go there, look at the left side, and you'll see a little featured links, featured tag section. And there's one called Open House. That's all the good for free public goodie stuff you can grab. There's CD stuff, there's book stuff, there's tablatures, there's videos, full-length concerts. Check it out, download that stuff, make sure you check out the welcome video and all of the reward incentives on the right side of the page, and I do hope you'll become a patron. We are a jolly fun crew, and you're making a lot of fun stuff happen for a lot of different people. Thank you guys very much. So, here we are with I'll Fly Away. First of all, this is a key for a lot of people who want to learn particular tunes. They're looking for the tablature online. Sometimes you can just sound this stuff out by listening to the melody. If you know the song really well, that's a lot easier than trying to learn a song that you don't know really well. Listen to the tune in your head and try and find it on the fretboard, preferably the melody string to start off with. I'm in the key of D. I'm in D-A-D tuning. And so what we'll start off with doing here is pick out the melody notes for I'll Fly Away. So we'll start off. First note right there is going to be F sharp at the second fret. And you go bum, 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 bum. What you want to be listening for is, where does that melody go when you start off from the first note? Does that melody go up, higher, or does it go lower in pitch? Don't think about direction of the fretboard. Think about lower or higher in pitch. Like this note here is lower in pitch than that note there, and vice versa. This note is higher than this note. That's a really extreme example over the course of a whole octave. But like this note here, now the pitch is going to start going up. And from that same note, going down. So by using that, sometimes the notes are going to skip around a little bit like it does with I'll Fly Away. Bum, 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 bum. So starting with this note, I'm going to go down. Nope. So I'm going to go to open, D, F sharp, to D. By the way, that's an interval of a third when you go from D to F sharp. The interval of a third can always be found if you sing Do a deer. Do a deer. That's a third. As you get used to listening to intervals, you'll be able to listen to melodies and really have a good idea about how far down the fretboard or how far up the fretboard you need to go in order to get that next note. So we're going down, bum, bum. We're out of string on the melody string, so we want to come over to the middle string to get our next note, and that's going to be open. A. Open on the middle string. And then come back to the melody string, open, and then back to our F sharp. Bum, 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 bum. Okay. So I went on the middle string again. Open on the melody string. Fly, that's the first fret on the middle string. Back to the melody string, open. Open on the middle string. Okay, so I'll go back over the A part again, and those notes, F sharp, E, sorry, F sharp, D, A, D, F sharp, E, F sharp, G, F sharp, going down, E, 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 D, and then you can go, okay, so that's going to be going from A to B. I'll fly away, back down to A. So this next note we know is a little higher than everything we've played so far. I'll fly away. So we're going to go up here to A. I'll bow to F sharp, fly away, oh glory. So it's really easy if you start thinking about the notes in your head, then just make sure you know whether they're going up or down, and then do the same thing with the pitches on your strings. I'll fly away, oh glory. We'll stay there on the D. Remember that little callback from the A part? D, melody string, and then B on the middle string. Fly, middle string, first fret, back to open D, melody string. Open middle string, A. And then pluck that middle string again. When, back to melody string, open. I die. Hallelujah, by and by, I'll fly away. Important to get your phrasing in there. So I'll do the B part again. A. Oh, almost forgot. In the morning. That's middle string. And we're going to go A, A, B, A. And then the middle string. When, open melody. I die. Hallelujah. By and by. I'll fly away. Okay. So there we have our melody for I'll Fly Away. Now here's the neat thing about figuring out your own arrangements. More than often, what's going to happen, more often than not, I'd rather say, when you've got a melody note, good songwriters throughout time have realized that the easiest songs to sing include melody notes that are actually part of the chord that supports that melody. And I'll Fly Away is no exception. It's one of the easiest songs to sing. And so what you're going to be looking for is, first of all, listen to that song in your head. And when you feel or hear that chord change, that is when you should also be changing the chord as well. But another important thing is, look for the melody note that you're playing while that particular chord is moving on past you. That note, more than likely, is going to be a part of the chord shape. So all you have to do is connect the dots and add two more notes. So we're starting off in D, and our three chords are D, G, and A. So we start off with D, which means we can go open and not chord anything. Right here, there's going to be a chord change. That chord is going to be G major. So what are we doing there melodically? We're going to open on the melody string. Luckily for us, if we play a 3-1-0, 0 is part of the melody, it's also part of the chord. And our next note, which is B on the middle string, fly, middle string, first fret, and then back to open on the melody string. Your fingers are holding that chord down. You don't actually have to go there and fret any of it. Isn't that cool? That's kind of the neat thing about melodies and chords. They fit together, so you can play the chords, pick through the chords, or arpeggiate through the chords. But really, you're flat picking those notes here. And then you don't have to worry about trying to find the melody note someplace else while you're trying to hold on to that chord. So, now, our melody note, we know that there's a chord change coming up here, and our melody note is at the first fret on the melody string. And so that's our big clue that what we're going to be doing here is going to involve a chord that is going to be one of the notes. And that chord is going to be A major. So we could either play a 101 chord, and I'll Fly Away goes back to D. Or we could play a 4-2-1 chord. I'll Fly Away. Whatever you'd like to do there to make it easier, 101's actually easier, but 4-2-1's got all three notes in the A major chord, A, C sharp, and E. So it's up to you. So let's do that again real quick. Like that. Now we'll get off into the B section. So we're going to start off with that D major chord rolling around, and basically the format doesn't change. We'll do D, we'll go to G, and then we will go back to D, and then we'll do our A at the end. That's the whole song, but that's not the end of this episode, because I want to show you how to put some get up and go inside of your strum, and maybe a couple of other little tips and tricks for people playing with the 1.5 fret, and make this even more special. First thing off, selective strumming. We're strumming along, we got our get up and go boogie thing happening, right? Now when I start picking those notes, I don't want to lose them in the grand scheme of things by strumming across all the strings all the time. Otherwise, it'll get lost and sound like this. So all we have is chords going on there. You can't hear the individual notes being picked because three strings getting the get up and go are getting buried in the mix. So what I like to do is I like to flat pick those notes to make them pop. I mean, just like that. You hit them and they go pop. And what'll happen is you'll just be kind of grooving on the bass string, which is holding down the foundation for your chord. So it gives you that nice solid root note, whether you're playing D, G, or A. And then you can kind of avoid strumming on the melody string and middle string and flat pick those notes instead. Now you'll get a little bit of drone and some bouncing around, but if you concentrate on flat picking those notes and keeping your rhythm going on the bass string or the middle string, if your melody note isn't living there, then you'll get something that sounds more like this. Now you'll see what I'm doing there is using afterbeats on the bass string. Try that little intro just to get a feel for how that's going to work. You're going to go and then come right back against the bass string. What we're doing in 4/4 time here is playing eighth notes. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and. So we're filling that up with rhythm, but not boogie rhythm, a real straight rhythm, so we can focus on picking that melody. And now I'm doing more of a boogie rhythm over here. Now notice with the I'll fly away on that A note, that right now I'm strumming on the bass and middle string, but the melody note I'm not touching. I'm not touching that string. So when it goes I'll, I can hit it and it decays naturally without me going like this. Which one sounds cleaner? This? Helps if I hit the right note. Or this. Selective strumming, using that to just sort of let the melody do what it needs to do. Melody is king, and do whatever you can to support that melody and be there for it, which includes not chopping it into little bitty pieces with the axe that is your pick. Okay, so let's go back over that, and I'm going to add a little something for the 1.5 strummers out there. So, next thing we're going to do here for you folks with the 1.5 fret, maybe wondering what the heck is this thing good for? It's good for a lot of cool stuff, including putting D7 chords into the mix. A D7 chord is a suspended chord, dominant seventh chord. It's been that kind of a day. A dominant seventh chord is basically a major chord with a fourth note added to that mixture, and that note is the flatted seventh or the minor seventh note of that particular scale. So in the case of D, the seventh note of the D major scale is C sharp. Take it down a half step, flatten it, it goes from C sharp to C natural. So D, F sharp, and A make D major, add a C natural, and you've got yourself a D7 chord. Now, we only have three string choruses right now, most of us anyway. Some of you are playing four string dulcimers, and I love you for that. But what we've got here is the ability to add a C down here in what I call the first position, open through the third fret. We'll be playing D, C, and F sharp. The A is not going to come into the picture at all, but that's okay. So what we're going to do is we're going to play open, 1.5, and 2. And that 7 chord, the dominant 7th chord, which is written D with a number 7 next to it, adds a lot of musical tension that is then released very nicely when you go to the G chord. Check out D7 going to G. Isn't that awesome? Tension and release. Resolution, closure, very nice. So you could throw in a 1.5, 2, 0, 1.5, 2, or you can do it inverted to 1.5. And I should probably be doing it that way to go from here. So I'm gonna try it this time this way. I'm gonna throw a little D7 into the action for some of the turnarounds here on I'll Fly Away. And I'm going to throw a couple of G chords, very, very quick, 0-1-3 G chords in to add a little bit of flavor as well. And maybe I'll add one more surprise at the end. We'll see what happens. Here it is, I'll Fly Away. I didn't do what I was going to do because I haven't practiced it that way. I didn't want to fail miserably, but I was going to put a B minor towards the end, which would be a chord substitution for D. So let's see, we go like a... B minor action as a chord substitution works in Amazing Grace as well. Anytime you have a nice dramatic moment you want to bring into a D tune, you can always throw a B minor into that D towards the end of the piece, and it sounds mighty nice. That's I'll Fly Away. Thank you guys very much for being here today and checking out Dulcimerica. I urge you to check out more of the episodes. Stick around for the after credit sequence and check out some of the other stuff. Also, don't forget the Dulcimerica episode guide, which was your guide, is your guide, to over 300 episodes here all over YouTube and the internets. So thank you guys once again for being here. And until next time, this is Bing Futch saying, play on, baby. Play on. Thank you. or one and a half fret shenanigans. Shenanigans, what a great word that is.